expectations versus reality. You're expecting one thing, but guess what? You're not gonna get it because this is reality and you're not that good. And that's what we're looking at today. Babe, has anything like this ever happened to you?
Yes.
You
catfished me. In a good way though. You know, I was expecting a very ugly man and I got this instead.
Very weird, and I wish you didn't tell him that. Yes, I did some weird thing where I convinced Claire I was
uglier
than I really am, and I'm still ugly, but she thinks I'm freaking hot, so it kind of works out. I will sell the program that can teach you guys to do that too. If you're interested, $7,000 a week, 52 weeks minimum.
Minimum.
But let's go look at these expectation fail, reality fails.
All right, this guy said that he bought a rug online for his room, and then he realized the importance of specifying
why. Spicifying. You spice it.
Specifying? Like, it's to specify, right?
Yeah, that's what it's specifying.
Okay. The size of the product that you're selling. So he bought this rug. He thought, you know, he got it for a steal, because if you didn't know,
rugs are expensive.
But it turns out it was, like, for a Barbie doll house.
The thing is, I don't feel bad for this guy, because that thing has one review. You never buy something with one review.
That's true.
Never.
That's true.
If there's like 40, that's pushing it. Okay, here we have some lady that says she will never again will I order a dress from China.
Never again.
So on the left, I'm assuming was the advertising picture where you have this lady in her white dress.
Beautiful.
Yes.
Stunning dress.
And then on the right is what she got in this, no offense to people that like this dress, this
ugly
green teal looking thing. Not, it's close.
No, it's not.
This person obviously wants to order their loved one, we don't know who, but their loved one, a beautiful bouquet of flowers. So they went online and they found this bouquet of flowers. And then what got delivered was probably not what they paid for.
That looks like a thing you buy at PetSmart for your fish aquarium.
Oh, it does look like right?
that. Like it
looks very fake. My mom said she ordered some cheap leggings for herself and they came in the mail. LMAO, I am done with life. She literally ordered doll leggings.
That's unfortunate. How, where do you like Amazon? Like who sells these pants?
Yeah, I'm sure Amazon. They're like for Bratz dolls.
But how much is a Bratz dolls pair of pants? And did this lady really think that she was gonna get a pair of pants for like $3?
Maybe.
Well, that's why you read the fine print.
Okay.
Okay, here we have a guy that might be slightly too big for this tent. Do they even make tents that small?
Yeah, like who is this tent? I know it says that it might be a children's tent, but is it? Is it a tent for ants?
I feel like as you're build.
Thanks.
I like that. God, I'm hot. But yeah, I feel like he bought a display version. I don't know. And at what point?
Oh, yeah. Those display versions are really cute.
Yeah, but like at what point did he know? Like, yeah, this thing's probably a little too small.
I don't know.
And once again, we have someone that did not read the fine print. And this says, my sister ordered boots offline for her Halloween costume. And this is what came in the mail. Those are some small little boots.
Maybe you honestly need to like hold a how to shop on Amazon seminar for all these people who don't read reviews. First of all, you have to read reviews if you're going to buy something on Amazon.
Yeah, I'd be interested to see how many reviews these had. Like no one's really buying new shoes for their G.I. Joe, I'm assuming.
Read the fine print, okay?
And plus, those combat boots in real life are probably like $300. You're not gonna find some steel on Amazon for like $1, okay? Like seriously, now I'm freaking ticked.
This girl says, how can my mom?
I mean my mom's car.
Order deck chairs for the garden for her, oh my God.
You remember that one time you made fun of me for not being able to read?
This says, let me just start on over. How can my mom order deck chairs for the garden and her and my dad, and this is what came. Am I reading this wrong?
How can my mom
get out of my car?
Order deck chairs for the garden for her and my dad, and this is what came. Crying face, crying face, crying face, crying face.
Yep, once again, you need to hold that Amazon seminar.
What are those for, Barbies?
Yes, they're all for dolls.
I just didn't know people bought launchers for their Barbies. And here we go. Someone actually almost did it right. They didn't go too small. They went way too long. And it looks like they have little flappers. Like they're, what are those things you put on your feet to swim? I don't know what they're called. Little
Flippers.
Flippers? Yeah. Flappers? Flippers. It looks like I have pants with flippers on it. Look at that. Wow. And now we're gonna spice it up a little bit, okay? We're gonna switch the mood and we're gonna react to memes that are following the same theme here. Expectation versus reality. Let's go.
New Year's resolution, expectation, you are just running every day. You are going to the gym. You are eating healthy. But then about, you know, January 2nd, the reality sets in.
Yeah.
And you are on the couch, eating ice cream, doing nothing.
This looks like me. I don't even have to wait for New Year's for this. I do it every day. I'm like, you know what? Tomorrow, I'm going to get back in the gym and get in shape. Then boom, I order a pizza. I'm like, I'll start tomorrow. Then the next day, I'm eating freaking pizza again. I'm like, maybe the next day. Maybe the next day. Every day for me.
I think everyone can relate to that.
I want pizza so bad now.
No.
Wait!
Now, if you grow up in a state that doesn't have snow, first of all, I'm actually truly sorry for you because building snowmen is one of the greatest things ever when you have a snow day. Andrew would probably disagree. He probably would say, no, on a snow day, we love to like be inside and play video games. Yeah, gamer.
Excuse me? I would build a bigger, better snowman than you in about a 15th of the time, okay? And then I would challenge you to a snowball fight, and I would destroy you in that as well because you didn't build a fort. While I was building my snowman, I also built an army of snowmen that would come and attack you in the snow. So don't you even dare pull this little, oh, video game rock on thing. I was playing video games while building snowmen, snow fort, and having snowball fights, and you think you would even have a shot at out destroying me in any sort of thing that comes to the snow? I've never even snowboarded. I would destroy you in that, okay? So I need you to stop crying and focus up.
Oh, I'm sorry, what?
You heard it all and you're just trying not to cry.
And I can honestly confirm that Burger King does this a lot.
Is this Burger King?
Yes.
Oh my God, I didn't even know they had hot dogs.
This is their hot dog, and then this is it on advertisement. This is it in real life, and you want to know what looks the same? Their taco, okay? It looks delicious in the commercials, and in real life, it is not what you think.
I am so glad we were not making YouTube videos when the Burger King hot dog came out. I had no idea.
Do you think they still have a hot dog?
I didn't even know they did at the first place. Is this a chili dog or is this a hot dog?
Hot dog king.
That's got to be a chili dog, right?
The Burger King hot dog.
I know, but look at the picture. If that's like what, that's a chili cheese dog. We can confirm that, right? Chili cheese dog here. That looks like a chili butthole dog.
Now this on the left is what Andrew just looks like on a daily basis, people. Okay? Don't ever question it. Don't ever think twice about it. Andrew is the man on the left.
I feel like there's not one characteristic about me that resembles the guy on the left. I can point out about 7 that make me look like the guy on the right. I have a beard.
Yes.
I kind of have long hair.
Yes.
I have a little bit of a dad bod.
No, you don't.
I wear jeans with a belt all the time.
No, you don't.
This guy on the left's got a Superman belt. Okay, bro, that's a little too much. I mean, I don't want to say anything too mean because he looks like he could rip my face off without even touching me.
That's true.
He's that big. Now, this one's very funny. I personally don't ever bite my lip because I don't want to be in pain. But if I was, I'm sure I might look like the guy on the top. I mean, let's be real. But for the sake of this video, I will go ahead and say I look like the guy on the bottom. That is Andy Sandberg. Like
Hot Rod. Give your best bite lip.
Was that hot or what?
Now, this is just very realistic.
You've been to the Great Wall of China?
No, but you know, you see these places that are very touristy on Instagram and you're just like, wow, look how beautiful that is. It looks so peaceful and it looks like its tranquility is
pure
and sound. And in all reality, it's crowded as butt because there's so many tourists there. And I'm sure during some seasons, it's probably not as crowded, like maybe not summer or not winter, maybe fall or spring, but I'm sick.
This looks like me and Claire now. Claire used to be the person on the left, but since she's been in my life, we sit on the couch and not have fun.
Actually, we really haven't done a lot on New Year's the last couple of years.
You're welcome. It's because every day is a party in my home.
Yeah.
Yep, very weird video here. It was pretty much just me and Claire arguing the whole time. But I mean, you expected us to be this happy, loving YouTube couple.
We've said this before.
And reality is, we are
normal. We've said
this before. Just like everyone else. No one is as happy as they seem, okay?
Ow.
If you're very happy, they're faking it. No one's happy. No one is happy. Look at this. She's trying to push me. I'm a freaking brick wall. Just like that snowman I built in the 3rd grade would be. Guess what? Oh, yeah, push. You're going the wrong way. I'm holding you up right now. If I let go, you go flying. We're almost out of film, though. Go quick.
Yeah, I
go
know.
Quick, go quick.
All right, make sure before you leave to like and subscribe, and we will see you guys in the next one.
Bye. Sorry, the film's almost out. It's about to shut off. Like 3, 2, 1. Is it off?
No. I think we have like 20 more seconds.
Do we wait it out? Okay, bye. God! It was freaking Disneyland.